If your goal is to move to a brand new city and get a fresh start, and you're wondering, how do I accomplish it? It just seems like such a big task. I need to know what I need to do little by little by little by little by little. Then Goal Spaces is the app for you. Goal Spaces is an inclusive community where you can meet like-minded people who are trying to accomplish the same goal as you. So let's say your goal is to move to Atlanta and you don't know where to start. In Goal Spaces, you can be in a space with people who are trying to do the exact same thing, where you have a task tracker that's counting every single task that you need to accomplish to get there. So the first thing could be to watch YouTube videos of people that live in the city or have lived in the city. The second thing could be, booking a flight to go there to get a vibe of the city, finding out where's the best places to live, where are the best school districts if you have children, what is the social atmosphere for. The purpose of Goal Spaces is to make sure that you can achieve your goals, and if you need some support, we got you. Download the app now. It's in the App Store and Google Play Store as well.
You could bet that, never gotta sweat that. 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 You could bet.
If you're considering moving to the A, then this video is for you. It's no secret that Atlanta has been dubbed the Black Hollywood, and that it's a place where if you want a new career change, you want to start a business, or just be in an area where there's more opportunities, then Atlanta's the place for you. Before you consider making that big jump, here's some things you might want to consider. Research the best neighborhoods. Research the best neighborhoods. You have to research the best neighborhoods. Atlanta's not a place where you can just look on the website, look at the reviews of the apartments, because some apartments give very much luxe on the website, gives very much nice neighborhood, but when you actually drive there, it's definitely catfish. I'm gonna help you guys out and give my take on the best places to live in Atlanta, the possible best school districts, and all the other things that I've experienced. Remind you, this is my personal experience. So that's it, yeah. So you have downtown Atlanta, and then you have the outskirts. And the outskirts could be Marietta, Kennesaw, Jonesboro, Morrow, all that other stuff. And knowing this is so important because if you have kids, that plays a huge factor in what school district they're gonna be in. If you're watching this video and you do have children and you're wanting to know what's the best schools for them to be in, APS is a great county along with Gwinnett County. And I want to say either Gwinnett County is better than APS. I don't have kids, but definitely double check your research. I have friends that are teachers or have been paraprofessionals, so they always let me know, like, based upon how the kids act, what type of school is best. When looking for a place, anything that says Old National, Riverdale Road, Flat Shoals, don't even think about it. Most high-paying jobs are gonna be either in the city or north of Atlanta. So when you're thinking about where you wanna live, make sure that you're understanding your commute, because your commute could be an hour, your commute could be 30 minutes. If you're in the city and you work in the city, that plays a vital role because it's like, do you need a car? Would you live in Atlanta? You need a car. That's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Do not move here if you do not have a car. If you live in Jonesboro or Morrow and you work in Marietta, in the mornings your commute is gonna be about 45 minutes on a good day, like a weekend, or close to like an hour and 15 minutes on a heavy traffic day. Let's not get into the fact that when it's time for you to come home, if you're getting off at like 5 or 6 o'clock, baby, you're really gonna be in traffic for an hour at least. If you can, try to get a work from home job that pays really well, or just make sure whatever job you get, try not to be no more than 45 minutes away. That way, it's just gonna be better for you, less wear and tear in your car, and it's less stressful. The next thing you need to do is get on social media, like YouTube, for example, and watch videos like this one, for example, of people's experience living in Atlanta. Make sure you have a healthy variety, and don't be biased, because there's some people that have moved to Atlanta it wasn't what they thought it was. They didn't vibe with the city and they didn't like it and they left. Listen to those videos too, because it gives you a perspective of what to expect possibly. And then also don't just take it for like word. Take it with a grain of salt, because everyone is different. So some people who are extremely introverted might have a hard time adjusting to the city because it's a big extroverted city. Some person that doesn't like too much like going on, they could be overwhelmed. Then you have some people that are like free spirit, outgoing. It's the place for them. If you don't have any family or friends in Atlanta, then I highly recommend watching videos because it gives you that perspective. Now, if you do have family in Atlanta and friends, then you already have a huge head start because you already know what to expect. You've probably been out here a few times. When you're watching videos of people that moved to the city and they regret it, don't let that discourage you at all. Because like I said, everyone's an individual. Some people will vibe with the city and then some people won't. One YouTuber that I had the pleasure of meeting moved to Atlanta from, I think, Kentucky. And we had breakfast one time and she was talking about how it was so hard for her to adjust to the city. She found it hard dating, even making some friends, and just adjusting overall. And she felt like the city wasn't for her, which was strange for me because I was like, oh my gosh, there's so much stuff to do here. You can do this and this and that. Because I'm a person that goes out, I meet so many people. Not to say that she doesn't, but her reason for wanting to move back was really valid because it just didn't work out for her, and that's okay. I am such a huge stickler on vibe and energy and being compatible. Not just being compatible with like a partner, being compatible with a job, but being compatible with a city. And no matter where you move, whether it's to Atlanta, to Houston, to Boston, to LA, make sure that you're compatible with the city. And the only way to do that is by visiting the city a few times. If you ask any like older person who came down to Atlanta years ago for Freaknik, there was a huge migration of them. They would come to Freaknik like every year. Then they started to not only just go to Freaknik, but they would just come to Atlanta to visit. And obviously the vibe of the city made them want to move there. And when they got here, whether it worked out for them or not, that was a driving force. And that's why I'm telling you that before moving here, you absolutely have to visit a few times. Visit to check out the nightlife. Visit to check out the culture, the food, the atmosphere. So, you know, get a sense of the people, because there's nothing more like, it's nothing more stressful than moving to a city and living there, uprooting yourself, your family, and you don't even vibe with the place. And the only thing you could think about is like, why the hell did I move here? And I'm ready to go home. There are so many resources that you can use to help you with your journey. For example, ProMove is a free, like, it's like a service. It's not like an app or anything. At least I don't think they have an app. But ProMove is a service that's completely free. You can go speak with a person. First, you create a profile and you say, I want to live in downtown Atlanta. My budget is $3,000 a month. That's the max rent I can afford. I haven't had any evictions, or I got like 3 evictions. I got no cats. And what happens is maybe like 24 hours later, someone will call you and then they will be your designated person. You give them all your information and your budget and they basically find apartments for you. They call around for you. They check if there's any rent specials. They even provide like a guesstimate to say, hey, well, my credit score is in the 400s or the 600s. What is gonna be the estimated deposit? If you're moving to Atlanta, you've never had like your first apartment before, or you got some stuff on your credit, ask them about risk fees, which are extra fees. It's a one-time fee though, that you pay outside of your deposit. With your risk fee, you don't get that money back. If you're moving to the city and you want to create your own social circle and, you know, get out there more. There's so many different accounts on Instagram where you can find things to do, like ATL Scoop. ATL Scoop is a really good Instagram account because it gives you information on things that's going on in the city that you need to know about. It's like the channel news, but a little better because sometimes they get more of the information than Fox 5 or 11 Alive. So definitely ATL Scoop. If you're a part of the LGBTQ plus community, there's so many events that they have, like Girl Crush ATL. Everyone knows about Eventbrite. If you want to find something fun to do in the city, whether it be at the lounge or just something kid friendly, definitely go to Eventbrite. For me and my little brother, we always like to do something super fun when he has a break from school. And I always just go on kids activities in Atlanta on a Sunday. And it could be like a puppet show at the Atlanta Children's Museum. It could be a fair that they have over there in Lilburn. There's so much stuff to do. Atlanta's a place that you're never bored. And if you're bored, it's because you either go out every single night. But there's no way that you can be like, oh, it's nothing to do. It's something to do all the time. Another thing to be mindful for when moving here is, baby, don't be fooled by the flashy lifestyle. They don't call ATL the Black Hollywood for no reason. Everybody here thinks that they're a celebrity. And we don't get starstruck by seeing, like, celebrities or rappers. You could be going to a lounge that's really popular and Lil Baby might walk in, Gucci Mane might walk. Like, it's just like so normal. So don't be fooled by that. A lot of times the reason why people aren't impressed is because everybody thinks that they're a celebrity, that they're a reality star, that they're just this most important person. Everybody here is main character energy. Atlanta is becoming such a big place for a lot of people to come and film things here, such as television shows and movies. The Walking Dead was filmed here in Atlanta and then in the outskirts. P-Valley is filmed here. And you know, Tyler Perry Studios is here too. So you have a lot of people that are in their actor, actress mode. I want you to also remember that a lot of people here are living above their means. And don't forget the CPN people too, because they definitely be living above their means, using CPNs to get luxury apartments, and then they don't pay. I'm not even gonna get into that, but it just goes to show, and I'm not knocking anybody hustle as long as you don't scam me. I'm basically saying that you will have people that have CPNs or they scam or do fraud, and you see them driving in a Bentley. You see them living in a nice luxe apartment bucket, and then you really think like, wow, I'm far behind, I gotta catch up with them. And it's like, no baby, no baby, no baby, no baby, you don't, no baby. The PPP loan people, no baby. Like, you just never know. You never know. That Mercedes at the red light could be about to get repossessed tomorrow. You never know. So don't go there and then live above your means. And that brings me to the point where make sure you don't get scammed. This is a scammer city. And it's a lot of hustlers here, a lot of slick talkers. I'm telling you, you will be parking it for an event and a homeless man could be there looking pretty much decent, because anybody could, you know, work the parking lot. It's like a low labor job. And you think you didn't pay for parking to go eat a sweet lounge, and then you come back, he gone, your car gone, and it was a tow sign there. Like, you have to be on the lookout, because it's the city, these people are hustling, so don't get scammed. Please do not come to Atlanta if you have no plan. If you're gonna come here and thinking that you're gonna DoorDash and Uber Eats and Grubhub your way into some money, it's not gonna happen. The city is extremely oversaturated with a lot of those drivers, and you're not gonna make any money. So don't think that that's gonna be a way for you to like hit the ground running. No, not even. Don't. That's all I have. Don't have any more right now. I will say this. If you have any questions related to moving to Atlanta, drop in the comments below. Let's all help each other. And that's just what it is. And good luck. See you in the next video.